So a short video about the B4 servo cover wobbles. The video is gonna be shaky, sorry about that. I just don't have much place in to handle the camera. So as you can notice here, the servo cover, it's already removed, as well as the piston. At the beginning, with the piston in place and the cover in place, I just grabbed a long extension, something like this. This is about perhaps 2 feet long. So I pressed it against the cover, just like that. And I kicked it a little bit with the hammer just to see the cover turning. So this way, I was sure it's not stuck in there. Next step, you absolutely, I think, maybe you can do with just something that you can grab the circlip, but I got this circlip pliers. It's a husky one, eight inches. It's really hard to get in there because of the dimension. If you can get something smaller but still strong, because the clip is pretty strong. So what I got, as you can see, I bent the tip of it. I got it bent a little bit, and then I managed just to get it to the clip like this. And actually what I did, I just grabbed the clip, I think just by one side, and move it towards the center. And at that moment, the clip just went out by just on one side, and I was pretty easy to grab it with my hand actually and to pull it from there. But I think you can grab it from both ears of the clip and just remove it like this. It's not so hard, but it's an awkward angle. And I'm working, you see, I have the well removed, just the well actually. Car is a bit raised, and this is the position you can get to get it to there. And you have these brake pipes in the way, but it's kind of tight, but it's still working. Now let's see the cover, where I removed it. So mine is a 2003. Supposedly, these covers were problematic from 2001, 2002, but I've heard some cars got them bad to up to 2005, actually. So most of the time, the upgraded covers are marked 2 decay or 3 decay. Well, surprisingly, mine is 1 decay, which usually it's for 2001, 2002. But if you turn it over, you see, it's a pretty neat design. It's not broken, it's working properly. So I'm gonna just place it back. But just to say, if you see one on your cover, it not necessarily means it may be an old model or this kind of redesigned model. And that's just the piston. I'm just gonna clean it up a little bit. You may watch for, sometimes there are wear marks on there. I've heard also the pistons are not all the same length. So while the covers may be interchangeable, but the pistons not necessarily. Also, once the clip, that's the circlip. I'll show you a tip about this. Once it was, the circlip was out, I have to just twist it a little bit, give it a kick, make sure once you pull the clip out, keep this with your hand, because sometimes it's just popping out like that, the piston follows, and anyway, you don't, especially with, if you had the splash shield on the car, you don't want to search for it, right? So just keep it with your hand. This one went out pretty easily. This one also, I have to push it a little bit inside, went out finally. Just a word about the circlip. I've heard people had issues with actually placing it back. Someone did a neat trick. I think just grab a pliers like this. I think it's channel pliers. I'm not gonna do it right now because I can't with one hand, and just crush it a little bit, not too much. I mean, permanently crush it, right? So at the end, it's just more closer here. So this way, just make sure it's still secure in there, but it's going to be much easier to place it back because it's going to be a less load on it. So it's not that bad of a job. I mean, it took me maybe 15 minutes to remove this. It's not too bad. Just make sure you have a tool like a snap remover or something like that. So I just noticed some roughness. This is the piston. You can see right on this place, right there. Both the piston is rough, and you can see it less clearly. The seal, rubber seal, it's also seems a little cut damage. All around it's okay, but just at that place it's rough. And that place was sitting at the lower, it's the bottom actually, sitting at the bottom of the piston. And when I went to check inside the transmission tool, it's gonna be harder for you to see. I just placed my finger in there, inside where the piston sits. Just try to find a better angle. So I just placed my finger just right inside to the end of the hole, and I can feel roughness too, right at the bottom of the hole where the damaged part of the piston is sitting. So this part of the piston was sitting up at the bottom of the hole. So I'll try just to get some gentle stuff like this thing, and just try to smooth it up the hole inside the transmission, and then I will switch this seal with the one from the servo cover. So this may explain why I had the 2nd-3rd upshifting, with some, mine was doing like a delay and then it was kicking in the third. So it was like waiting to kick in the third. The engine revs were just normal, not like when it's sleeping, but it was just having a delay and then bam into the third gear. Not too hard, but was kind of annoying. So this roughness might explain that thing. In the end, I used my pray bar configuration, and with the cover depressed, I just blocked an extension like this, and the extension, it's pushing against the torsion bar, and this point, I don't have the circlip already in there, but as you can see, the cover, it's depressed, so I can just get the circlip. I will use the pliers for the circlip, so I'll get the circlip in there with the pliers and try to slide another finger or another hand and put the circlip back in place.